Hi, my name is Sophie, and I'm going to be describing the new feature in Stateflow, exit ports. A common problem when modeling a process is to need to describe the possible ways the process can terminate. We can see that this model describes one success and two failure paths using boundary crossing transitions out of the state solar panel manager. This works, but it makes it impossible to convert the state into an atomic subchart. If we use mapped variables to communicate across the boundary, we introduce a one-step delay. Now let's look at fixing this problem using our new feature, exit ports. If we select an exit port from the palette and then give it a descriptive name on the canvas, you can see that it has spawned a boundary port to go along with the internal exit junction on the inside of the state. If we zip ahead to where we have exit ports for every one of the outgoing paths, you can see that we now have a descriptive interface for the state, and we're able to show the ways it can terminate. If we step forward in this diagram, you can see entering the first substate, then the second substate, and finally taking the success exit port out to the final state. Notice that we are also now able to convert this state to an atomic subchart, and the exit ports remain on the boundary, describing the ways the state can terminate. Notice that we are also able to use this logic within a linked library atomic subchart. If we copy-paste the internals of the state into a library chart, now we can see the interior exit junctions at the chart level, but there is no boundary yet for the pair exit ports to exist on. If we navigate up to the Simulink level of the library and copy-paste that stateflow chart into another stateflow chart, we will get a linked library atomic subchart in that second chart. And you can see moments later the boundary ports will spawn on this linked library atomic subchart. Jumping ahead to where we've connected these together, you can see that these ports define the output paths of that state without needing to refer to internal logic. And if we execute this chart, we can see that it behaves the same way. First, we enter the upper internal state, then the second state, and finally we leave via the success port, entering the lower external state. Now let's show one final example of a library of actions to control a robot. You can see our robot can move in a particular direction, returning via done if a movement is successfully completed, or via hit if an obstacle is hit. We can rotate, turning either left or right based on which input port we use, and this action will return via an unnamed exit port when complete. Our robot's goal is to reach a dock, and we need to be able to contact the dock to see if we've moved nearer to it or further away. Now let's copy-paste these three linked library atomic subcharts into our robot project chart. You can see as they are pasted, boundary ports will spawn on the edges of these objects, showing the user how they can be called and how they can terminate. The ports form a public interface for the linked library atomic subcharts, communicating their functionality to the library user. The library robot component is used in creating a visualization we will see shortly. Now let's jump ahead to where the logic is all connected in our project. You can see that if a movement action completes successfully, we will communicate with the dock to see if we've moved closer to our goal. On the other hand, if we hit an obstacle, we will rotate to the left to avoid that obstacle. When a rotation action completes, we'll return to the movement action. If we've moved away from the dock since our last contact, we'll need to turn to move in a different direction. Additionally, if we've gotten very close to the dock, we need to slow down so we don't overshoot it. Now let's look at a visualization of our project in action. The blue line represents the robot's progress as it moves through the field of red obstacles towards the green goal. You can see that when it hits an obstacle, it has to turn to go around it. When the robot gets close to the goal, it slows down. Thank you for your time, and I hope you look forward to utilizing exit ports in your next Stateflow project to make your Stateflow work more componentizable and to generate reusable Stateflow charts.